This is Russ Kingston talking about, actually, it's not an action scene, but it's a great suspense scene in an Alfred Hitchcock film noir from 1950 called Stage Fright. Now, there's three characters. They're all actors. Charlotte is the most successful. She's a stage actress. And Johnny is in love with Charlotte. Charlotte is married. But there's an acting student named Eve. She's in love with Johnny, and she's his friend. The film, after the first couple of minutes, we see a flashback, and Johnny is talking to Eve in her car, describing what happened that morning. He goes to his apartment door when he hears the bell ring, and Charlotte is there, and she's wearing a white dress. The lower half of it is covered in blood. What happened, you know? Well, she had an argument with her husband. Her husband, you know, found out that she was having this affair with Johnny and slapped her around and started punching her and beating her up. And so Eve grabbed something to defend herself with, hit him over the head, and killed him. Now, the problem is she's got to go on stage that night. She's wearing a dress with half of it's bloody. So what can she do? So Johnny volunteers, "I'll go back and I'll get a fresh dress for you and bring it over." So Johnny goes back there. He sees the body on the floor. He goes into the wardrobe and he takes out a fresh dress. As he's walking out, he decides to make it look like it was a robbery gone bad. So he smashes a window and he throws papers all over her desk. And he's picking up one of the photographs that actually shows a scene from one of their productions in which Charlotte is there, and he's one of the dancers in the act. And while he's reminiscing about that, Charlotte's maid comes in, sees the body, and and suddenly, you know, he realizes he's got to get out of there because, you know, the body has now been seen by the maid, and he's the only guy there. So he starts to go a different way down to the staircase, and as he's going down the staircase, Charlotte comes out over the banister, looks down, and sees him. Now, Charlotte knows this guy because, you know, they all know each other. So Johnny goes back to his apartment and gives Charlotte the dress, and she thanks him, and she changes, and she goes out. Now, all of a sudden, Johnny is coming to the foreground, and he's now envisioning what's going to happen next. And he's imagining that the maid is talking to police inspectors, describing Johnny because she knows him. He's imagining that one of the inspectors is looking at a phone book, and his hand is scanning down the phone book. Suddenly, Johnny looks at the phone in his apartment. All of a sudden, it rings, and he goes, "Ugh!" And he starts to reach for it, and he realizes he better not answer it. What happens is he looks to the window and he sees these two cops there, and he starts to grab a suitcase, and he realizes, yeah, it's too bulky, and he grabs his bloody dress and sticks it under his jacket and smooths it out, and he goes down to the stairs where his front door is. He opens it up, you know, and they introduce themselves as inspectors. "Do you mind if we talk to you for a minute?" No, fine, come on in. And they come in, and he suddenly scoots around them, and he runs out to his car, and he slams the door shut, and they run right out after him, and they're banging on the door, trying to open it, trying to get him to open it. Of course he doesn't, and he takes his key out, and he puts it into the ignition, and like they start smashing on the window, and he points at the window, and there's a close-up, and it says safety glass, so they can't get in. Now they start like elbowing and really smashing the window, and they actually punch a hole, like a crack in the window, and now the car scoots off, and it's going down the street, and we see in this one shot, his car goes across the intersection, and just as the police car chases from behind, before he can cross the intersection, a team of horses walks by carrying this freight wagon that's like about 20 feet long, and it slowly crosses in front, blocking the intersection, and it fades out. And the next shot is Johnny at the acting class meeting the girl Eve, who has a crush on him, and he gets away. I love stuff like that.